In this tutorial, we will discuss the different views of the Chimp software. The views are flexible and can be used for all purposes. In the main screen on the top left and right, you will find the main views of the software. The views on the left have a fixed layout, but you can adjust them individually. The right-hand views in the software are views for setting, patching, backup, and network settings. These cannot be modified. The external screen has a number of views that are also visible on the main screen. Unique to the external screen is the queue list view. The names of the views contain numbers. These numbers correspond with the hotkeys associated with the view. Each view can be opened by pressing the View button or by pressing Open, plus 0 to 9, where each digit on the numerical keyboard opens the corresponding view. To switch views on the external screen without touchscreen, you can use the hotkey Infinity, plus, Open, plus 1 to 5. View 1, called Programmer, is an overview of four separate widgets. The top left, bottom left, and top right widgets are individually customizable. The bottom right widget is the Programmer window. It is not customizable. It will always be in this spot. The three customizable widgets allow you to choose what is visible in each widget. The console remembers which settings you choose when switching between views and recalls the widgets you last set when you switch back to the view. View 2, called Playback, is a view with three widgets. You can customize all three widgets. The right widget is larger, making information from queue lists or magic sheets, for instance, easier to see. View 3, called Quad Split, is a quadruple screen view. You can customize all four widgets in this view. This view is often used for busking shows. View 4, Half Split, is a two-part screen. These two large widgets can be customized, and because of their size, they can show more info at the same time. View 5, called Magic Sheet, is a large widget for magic sheets. The magic sheets are covered in a separate tutorial. View 6, Network, opens the widget with the tracking backup state of the console. View 7, Setup, opens the setup menu for patching, networking, show settings, etc. View 8, opens the widget for saving, loading, and exporting shows. View 9 does not open a widget, but it is a direct operation. This button locks the console. View 0, Quick Save, is a direct operation just like View 9. This button saves the show quickly. This button turns green when pressed. The console confirms that the show has been saved successfully. On the external screen, views 2 to 5 are identical to the views of the main screen. View 1 is named Queue List and opens a large widget for the selected queue list. This widget also contains the basic executor controls such as go, off, pause and back, select, assert, skip minus, and skip plus. In the different widgets, you can choose different pools. The same pools are available for almost all customizable widgets. In this tutorial, we will explain the different pools based on the widgets in the upper right corner of the programmer view. In the fixtures pool, you can see all the fixtures that have been added to the show. In this pool, you can also see the visualization values of each fixture, like dimmer, position, gobo, color, etc. In this view, you have the highlight, blind, and solo buttons available, which are often used when selecting fixtures. The groups pool contains all the groups of fixtures that you have saved. In total, you can create 100 groups of fixtures. In the presets pool, you can access the presets of all the parameters. In this pool, you have access to the buttons direct action and auto generate. When direct action is enabled, you can trigger a preset directly, without selecting a set of fixtures in advance. If you have selected a set of fixtures and then press the Auto Generate button, the console will create a series of pre-programmed presets for the chosen parameter. You can use the drop-down menu to manually set the different parameter pools. By choosing the Link to Programmer value in the drop-down menu, this widget will change the pools according to the parameter selected in the programmer. In the queue list view, you can see the settings and queues of the selected queue list. If the link selected button is activated, the queue list view switches to the overview of queues of the selected queue list as soon as another queue list is selected. If the scroll button is enabled, the queue list will automatically scroll along with the triggered queues. The usage button shows you which executors are using the list. The Queues button switches the widget to the queue list overview. Here, you can adjust all the settings of the queues. The Settings button switches the widget to the queue list settings. When switching to the queue list settings, the scroll button changes to Load Defaults and Save Defaults buttons. These allow you to save an executor's settings so they are assigned to newly saved queue lists by default in the future. You can also use the Load button to adapt existing settings to the selected queue list. In the Executors pool, you will find the Virtual Executor buttons. These buttons can be linked to queue lists or groups, just like the faders and buttons in the console. In total, there are 128 virtual executor buttons, divided into 4 pages. You can switch between these pages by using buttons 1 to 4 in the executor widget screen. The Protect button locks empty buttons to block the Assign Executor pop-up during a show. The Magic Sheets widget is identical to the Magic Sheet view. However, it can now be inserted in different places without having to switch back and forth between views. In the Queue List pool, you can find all programmed queue lists. In the Output widget, you can see to which fixture values are sent and what these values are. You can use the toolbar to select different options. By enabling all fixtures, the console will show the output for all fixtures, regardless of the selection. If you enable selected only, the console automatically filters out the selected fixtures and only shows the output for the selected ones. The Value button allows you to read the values that each parameter of each fixture is sending. The Source button shows you the location from which the values originate. The Effect Source button shows the location of the effect the values come from. In the DMX Output widget, you can read all bit values that the console sends out per DMX and per universe in real time. You can use the drop-down menu to select different universes and the widget will display the output of the chosen universe. The Fader page and Executor page buttons in the top center of the screen let you view, edit, name, delete, and move the available fader pages. The Go To page button allows you to go directly to the selected page. The hand symbols make it easy to reorder the pages. Thanks for watching.